Marita Gomsrud has come to help do this review video. Marita, come on in.
Hello. Hello, Jonas, Steinar, Mikkel og Didrik. Nå gleder jeg meg veldig til å prøve ut denne hengekøya deres.
I made her memorize all that. Welcome to I Might Be Chad, an idiot's guide to Los Angeles. I know, we're just gonna jump. The Amok Draumr. The Amok Draumr 3.0. Sorry, all you guys. It's Norwegian. I decided I have to do a review on this hammock. Now, I've already owned the tent-style tree tent, the flight. That's a great tree tent. We took it up to Zion, got caught in a blizzard in it. But again, I'm pretty sure the overall weight on that thing is a little over 7 pounds. That's a heavy backpacking tent. You know, with the Eno and all those other super light, you can get hammocks this small now. It'll just fit in your pocket. But the problem is that I don't sleep on my back. I sleep on my side and I sleep on my stomach. I went out and I set up this hammock, and for the first time ever camping, I was actually sad I was going back to my real bed after the camping trip. It's always opposite. You're always like, oh my God, I can't wait to get back to my bed. So let's show you the hammock setup. Okay guys, so here we go. Here is the hammock. It is actually a lot smaller than I anticipated. Bag is actually attached to the hammock, so no risk in losing the bag. You essentially pull out one of the straps. I've seen people do this different ways. Some have hooked it from underneath, and that's the way that Jonah, how do you say? Eunice's video showed it upside down. And other people I've seen show it over the top. So I'm not sure exactly which one's proper, but I'm gonna do it like this. So you have this little flap here, and this protects the tree, which is a nice touch. Protect the tree. So now I can pull out the hammock. I got everything tangled when I packed it in, not preparing for the review video. Okay, now we're gonna take the other strap, like so. And we got a little protector here as well. And I have a feeling we're probably gonna have to tighten these up quite a bit. Okay, so now the whole hammock comes out of the bag. Okay, you wanna make sure everything's untangled first. Make sure your lines aren't twisted or anything. And now we can use this strap here to slowly start evening it out. So the most important thing is that this is completely straight across. You want these straps to kind of be at a 30 degree angle. If you don't, there's a sweet spot that this hammock has. Now it's also noted, you don't want to hang it too high because again, it's a little tricky to get into. Let's see if this angle change helps a little bit. Looking good. That's not too bad. Now I'm going to say this might still be a tad bit high, but it's not too bad. As you notice, there's a little foot box here. So this is where your feet are gonna go. So if you come look on this side, we have a little pocket here. And this is what you slide the air mattress into. This little baffle goes under over the top of it, and then you just zip it up. And you essentially are sleeping on a floating air pad, air mattress. It's amazing. All right guys, so now for the pad. Now there's something extremely interesting that you have to know about this. I'm glad I watched a couple review videos on it, but you need vertical baffles so that the hammock just doesn't collapse. If you use horizontal baffles, it's not gonna hold you up. It has to hold up your feet and it has to hold up your head. So they have their own brand, which is the Fuel Long Wide, which is 78 inches by 25 inches. You wanna get the exact same dimensions if you're not gonna go for that pad. The Fuel Long Wide is 2.24 pounds. That's still, I mean, there's tents that weight, but they are insulated. And since you are sleeping in a hammock and you don't have an underquilt, which if any of you don't know what an underquilt is, it's essentially a sleeping bag underneath the hammock that keeps cold air from going underneath you while you're trying to sleep. I've done some winter camping.
Oh wow, your feet look normal again.
Yeah, it looked normal.
Thank God.
My first time during this day that I feel my foot warm.
Yeah,
I'm never ever gonna do it again. So, I went for the Big Agnes Ultra Core Long Wide, same dimensions. And the Big Agnes comes in at 1 pound, 6 ounces, which is over a pound difference. So again, I'm trying to cut weight as much as I can because what you're trying to do is justify comfort to weight. The hammock, the pad, and the tarp altogether is about 5.6 pounds. Ah, technology. So now, let's put this thing in the hammock. Okay, so we're gonna put the hammock in from the backside right here. There's a little pocket. And I found that setting it up after this and kind of sliding it on, like a little sweater, like a little Christmas sweater. What I suggest if you have a different brand, you make sure this is facing up at the very back. So if you do need to make an adjustment, you can just slide this out a little bit. And I don't even have it fully inflated, but I was just really afraid I was gonna bust this zipper. Like, it takes a little bit of practice. You have to do this a few times. So as you can see here, it's great that the bag is just attached directly to the hammock. It's sewn right in. So I like that. It's also a great little extra storage compartment. This little slit is good to grab the hammock and slide it in. You can get your arm in here and help pull it. So what we have to do right now still is put the foot box in its proper place. But the foot box is a really nice touch. And you need to find that sweet spot. I'm not quite at 30 degrees like I want to, but you wanna have a tent's ridge line. You wanna make sure it's even. So I'm gonna demonstrate how you get in the tent. Now, they say the technique is to fold this back, but my legs are too short to be able to do that and it's too high. So my technique is I get on the edge and I use these straps to kind of lean back and slide into the hammock. And again, you are looking for this like sweet spot. And if you come in and look at these buckles, so if you see these buckles here, I can either pull to bring the back end up or I can loosen them up like this. So you wanna have these all the way down if you want it to go into flat mode. Just gonna push up on the buckle. Now this goes to flat, same thing with the bottom ones. I'm pretty damn flat. This is actually pretty nice. Like, I don't sleep like this. I sleep on my side. Here's the best part. I sleep on my side sometimes. Most of the time I sleep on my stomach. So let's test this completely flat theory. But look at this, man. Oh, all day. Oh, I was so comfortable sleeping like this. But this isn't too bad. This goes into chair mode. So what you do is you pull on these, brings up the back like so, and then you just bring up the chair a little bit where the feet are. And look at this, full-on camping chair, automatic camping chair, floating camping chair luxury. Okay, so now here's a really great feature. Again, you're kind of open, you're like, what about mosquitoes? Well, what they did is if you pull this little flap right here, they have sewn in an integrated bug net. And the first thing you want to do is connect this to your ridge line, like so. And then you simply zip this all the way around, you're completely protected. Now, I did suggest that they maybe put a couple more of these little connectors so you can connect it up here and have a little bit more room inside. But other than that, it's not claustrophobic. There's a little cinch here. So here I am inside, and I got quite a bit of room. We got the little clip to be able to cinch it right here. I like how there are no separate parts, like the net isn't separate. Everything's sewn into each other. So we'll just take this, stuff it back in, like so. This is Norwegian mines at its greatest, is what it is. Okay, so now here we are with the tarp. This is the Amok 3.0 4th edition. I love this tarp. I've never actually owned one, but what was great when we were in Zion, when I didn't have it over the hammock, we were actually able to just use it as a regular tarp above our little campsite. So let's check this tarp out. This is essentially your tarp. So this is a 270 centimeter ridge line, about 9 feet, which is plenty of room. This weighs in at 21 ounces or 0.43 pounds. If you wanted to go super ultralight, you could get the Dyneema Cuban fiber tarp with doors, which comes in at a crazy 6.7 ounces, but it comes at a cost, it's about $330.
God damn, Jimmy.
The Cuban fiber's great, but it's it's more expensive than this whole setup. What's also great about this tarp is that it comes with the steak bag, again, sewn into the tarp. So you get these really nice, I believe these are aluminum tarp steak. This is pretty, this is about as light as you can get. So you get 6 of these with it. And my only suggestion is some doors would be great on the side. But other than that, that's not much to complain about. It's a super light tarp. I like that it's dark blue, so it's gonna keep the sun out. Okay, so here we are inside the hammock. This is with the tarp on. Ample room on both sides. Getting a beautiful sunset right now. I like this. This wasn't too bad. I didn't get cold at all. So I think the blue is a nice choice. My only thing is I wish they'd come out with a few different colors. I would love a black, a red, a camo. A camo would kill. It'd be the best selling tarp that people would pick is the camo for sure. But the blue is nice. I love dark blue. It's perfect. Okay, let's do a full 360. There we go. Nice. Urban camping at its finest. Okay, Jonas, have I got a surprise for you, just to show you how much I care about this review video. All the way from Sietra, Norway, famous filmmaker, author, actress, director, billionaire philanthropist, Marita Gomsrud has come to help do this review video. Marita, come on in.
Hello. Hello, Jonas, Steinar, Mikkel, and Didrik. Nå gleder jeg meg veldig til å prøve ut denne hengekøya deres.
I made her memorize all that. So she just flew in literally 10 minutes ago. So she's about ready to try this amazing hammock for the first time.
This is good. This is really good.
Okay. And do you really think you could sleep like this?
Yes.
And is it more comfortable than any tent you've ever slept in?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
I feel surprisingly really safe. I'm stable. I don't feel like I'm going to fall out or roll out in any way.
Right.
I feel really supported. It's the right amount of support as far as sleeping on my stomach goes. So cool.
There you go.
I'm inside with the mosquito net, feeling really protected. It's great. Yeah, no mosquitoes are definitely coming in here. I feel very safe. So here's my view from the outside. Okay, de henger her. Køya var kjempefin. Skikkelig stilig design, veldig komfortabel. Jeg kan faktisk sove I den, både på magen, så det var kjempedeilig. Utrolig kult. Jeg kjempefornøyd. Jeg synes det var veldig, veldig bra. Bra jobba, gutter. Kjempefint.
And then we have our second guest, all the way from Araguari, Brazil. Photojournalist, model, billionaire, and philanthropist, Aline Nader. Here's for you, that boy.
Aline Nader.
Aline Nader. Yes, earned your name. Araguari, Brazil.
Oh my God, I feel so comfortable.
So comfortable?
I can stay here all my day reading my book.
Oh, my day.
Really good. Super comfortable. Safe.
Yeah. Perfect.
Dope. It's amazing. It's super practical and I can bring to the waterfall and to the beach. I can stay here in the urban camping.
Yeah. You are in.
No mosquitoes. Yeah, there's a lot of space for everything that you want. A lot of pockets. We can fit like books and bottle of water and almost a backpack. It's really good. Good part that I have a lot of room for my feet. What is not hard because I'm super small person. It's pretty comfortable. Good night. Have a great day. So this is all the things that you can put inside the pockets in this hammock. So let's try.
Sunglasses, here you
sunglasses.
Go.
Sunglasses.
On the way.
Protected. Whiskey. I have to find a nice place for whiskey. Let's do this. Perfect. Hiking shoes. Oh my God, you want a tag. Tag your... Yes. Let's this see. Is awesome. This is going with me. Yes, magazine. My favorite.
Kindle.
Right here. I don't want to miss my Kindle during the night.
Oh
my God! Yes, this is like my baby. It's gonna sleep like here. The drone is gonna sleep in my heart. Like, there we go, safe and sound. I really need this when I'm camping. I really need this. Luna, my ukulele. My favorite. Look how amazing! All these things here inside in the hammock with me.
Looks like you brought your home.
Love it. Just like a house. Like a house. What else do you need? What else? What else? Everything here.
Thank you, Aline Nader, for coming in. Have a safe flight back to Brazil.
Yeah.
Luis, our cameraman. Come on in, Luis. Come on,
come on.
Real quick. Luis. Luis Trujillo, not the soccer player, but he did all the amazing work on the new Ronin S today. We'll see you on the next one, guys.
Yay!
Yay. Everyone's standing now.
Yeah, come on!
All right, on.
Oh, I feel.